Thank you for plugging into this Family Life News podcast, streaming issues-driven, family-focused news. Welcome back to another edition of Issues in Education. Mondays during the Noon Report, we give you a front row seat to what's happening in the classroom with Dr. Ralph Kerr at the Teaching and Learning Institute. Dr. Kerr, don't know, were you a front row or back row student back in the day? Which was it?
I was under the seat as much as I could.
Well, you did pretty well because you've done it all in education, and that's why we have you on and love to spotlight not just what you say, but the organization that you represent, the Teaching Learning Institute. Well, hey, let's start with a report on how New York is spending its COVID cash. According to this report, not too well. Districts have spent less than 10% of the funding meant to improve learning loss from the pandemic. That begs the question, Ralph, if we're not spending the money on what we're supposed to be spending the money on, then where's that money going?
Well, it's either going or not going a couple of places. First of all, at the district level, what I've found is that districts are not spending that money on anything. They're just holding it and creating sort of a rainy day fund, assuming, and this assumption is correct, that over the next 2 or 3 years, the state is not going to be able to continue to give the kind of state aid that they have in the past. So districts have decided to just kind of save the money till that day comes, which obviously was not the intent of the COVID-19 funding. The other part at the state level, though, is I think really worse, and that is they have used $1 million of that money to create a new position at the state ed department called the Chief Diversity Officer, and that they're going to use $1 million in supporting that position and the work that that person is going to do. Again, not the intention of the COVID-19 funding for public education.
Yeah, and that brings us to the next question. When you talk about diversity, inclusion, equity, there's a lot of social, emotional learning, a lot of buzzwords for critical race theory. In Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, I could not believe the story when I saw it. I had to read it twice just to make sure I had my facts straight. A district there says it's going to defy any law from Harrisburg that would prohibit teaching that any race is superior to another race. That's basically what CRT is. The district calls this House legislation harmful. Why would any school district want to promote one race over another?
Well, because teachers in that district and parents in that district believe that that's what should be done. The reports I read said that several parents and teachers talked to the board about it and really encouraged them to defy the law. It also is worth noting that another bill that was passed in Pennsylvania talked about allowing parents to opt their children out of curriculum that had sexually explicit content. And that same district in Pennsylvania, the board has voted against that law. And finally, there was another law that would prohibit instruction on gender identity issues under the fifth grade. And again, in that school district, parents and teachers have urged the board to defy that law as well. So at least on three fronts, that district is way out of line. And I would just say, as I've said so many times, this is the reason why parents need to be involved in their school district.
Very well said, Ralph. And then finally, there was a story kind of, when you're talking about racism in school, former Spanish teacher, we're getting kind of in the weeds on this, but interesting that this teacher in the Buffalo area, Williamsville, taught Spanish for over 30 years. She is suing that district for $1.5 million. She had been fired after word got out about an assignment that she had given to middle schoolers. Many had construed this as blatantly racist. Does this teacher have a case, in your opinion?
Well, the interesting thing here is that there's got to be more to this story. I, in fact, tried to find the contract on their website, and I couldn't see it. But there's no way that any district could possibly fire a teacher for one controversial assignment. That just doesn't happen. Specifically this teacher, who obviously would have tenure as well. So there's a whole lot more to this story than just this one incident. And I don't believe the teacher will be successful. It's a waste of her money and the district's money as well.
All right. Just like that, we are out of time. But hey, if you have questions about what the Teaching and Learning Institute is, why do you exist there in beautiful Houghton, New York? Well, Dr. Ralph Kerr would love to hear from you. And, you know, Ralph, you get emails from time to time. If you call or if you write or if you email, we may bring some of those discussions up on the air. So give the good doctor a call. Ralph, where can they find you?
They can find us at yrun.org, yrun.org.